Welcome to Today Update. Please subscribe and check notification box to get all breaking news alert. Donald Trump's announcement that his administration would roll back the Obama-era policy mandating that employer providing health insurance plans cover contraception at no out-of-pocket cost to employees was met with immediate pushback and criticism. And two Democratic state attorneys general have added lawsuits to that opposition. California Attorney General Xavier Becerra and Massachusetts Attorney General Maura Healey's, who between them represent over 46 million Americans, have both filed lawsuits against the Trump administration to stop his unconstitutional overreach. In his statement, Becerra noted that the administration wants businesses and corporations to control family planning decisions rather than patients and doctors. These anti-women's health regulations prove once again that the Trump administration is willing to trample on people's rights, Becerra said. The California Department of Justice will fight to protect every woman's right to health care, including reproductive health care. We'll see the Trump administration in court. In her announcement, Healey was forthright in her assessment of Trump's move, declaring that it represents, simply put, an all-out attack on women in this country. She pointed out that allowing an employer to essentially impose its religious beliefs on its employees, which is what this new rule would do, as well as give space for the more amorphous moral objection from an employer, is a violation of the Establishment Clause of the Constitution. She added that the rule would further violate the principle of equal protection under the law, as well as the norms set out by the Administrative Procedure Act. Speaking to MSNBC's Ari Melber Friday evening, Healey expanded on these points, noting that there are already religions protections under the law, following the Supreme Court's ruling in Sebelius v. Hobby Lobby Stores Incorporated in 2014. Trump's White House has already telegraphed their disdain for the very real concerns raised by people like Becerra, Healey's, and many others. When asked during a briefing what she would say to the millions who would be negatively impacted by this rule, Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders actually laughed during her answer, as she brushed off the issue, while also lying about it for good measure. The ACLU has also filed a lawsuit against the administration to block the new rule, on behalf of their own members as well as those of the Service Employee International Union United Healthcare Workers West, CUUHW. Dave Regan, president of CUUHW, was unsparing in his condemnation of Trump's decision. With the stroke of a pen, the Trump administration has shamelessly attempted to rip away the rights of untold numbers of women to receive essential health care, under the warped facade of religious freedom, he stated. Apparently, he continued, religious freedom to this administration is the freedom to allow bosses to make medical decisions for and discriminate against female employees. Women and others who need reproductive health care will pay the price, figuratively and literally, for Trump's blatant pander to the religious right. And with this announcement coming on the heels of the House GOP passing a 20-week abortion ban, it is abundantly clear that the conservative war on women is still alive and well. But so is the fight to stop it.